He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Don't obsessively follow what you don't know anything about. Don't become a follower of things you don't fully know. Then he says, hearing, seeing, and your exaggerated emotions, your impassioned emotions, are all going to be asked about. إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادِ كُلُّ أُولَئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. And he makes a big deal out of them, for those of you who are familiar with Arabic, even though they're غير عاقل. So it's كُلُّ تِلْكَ. But he says كُلُّ أُولَئِكَ تَفْخِيمًا. He actually aggrandizes, hearing is a big deal, your perception is a big deal, and how you feel is a big deal to Allah. And he makes it a big deal by calling them أُولَئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. So Allah is saying that this is a very important thing that will change your worldview essentially, and how you will end up before Allah. The beginning part, don't follow what you don't know about. There are some simple things I want to share with you about that besides our exposure to the Qur'an. Of course, in a religious sense, we don't follow anything in the religion unless we know about it ourselves. Unless we can say with confidence this is actually coming from Allah's own words, or it's coming from the Prophet's words, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The thing is, just because something is in the Qur'an and you heard it, you heard somebody say this ayah is in the Qur'an, this is what it says. Oftentimes what we do nowadays when we have discussions among each other, the sad reality is the vast majority of us, including myself, don't have much knowledge. We don't know a lot. We've heard snippets here and there, we know a little bit of here, a little bit of there, and we sometimes share things with each other in order to advise one another, and we'll quote an ayah, we'll quote a hadith and things like that, but oftentimes we don't really know what the ayah and hadith are actually talking about. And we assume just because we've heard a translation of the ayah, or we kind of know what the ayah means, it applies in this situation immediately. Like for example, somebody quotes a hadith at somebody else. You know, you should do this because the Prophet ﷺ said this. Okay, well, where did he say? Well, it's in Bukhari, it's sahih. Excellent, it's an authentic hadith. Got it. Who did he say it to? When did he say it? What else did he say about the subject? How was this understood by the person he talked to? What was their reaction after that? Did they understand it exactly the same way you're trying to make me understand it? Or was there something you don't know? There are contexts, there are larger stories, you know, just like for example, two of your friends are talking in the back, and you walk by and you hear one sentence. One of the friends says to the other, I'm gonna kill you, bro. And you just heard that part, I'm gonna kill you, bro. And you walk away like this, I'm gonna report this to the police, because this brother is gonna kill that brother. It's a sahih, authentic recording. It's true, he said it. But he was just saying, I'm going to destroy you on the basketball court. He was just saying, you better stop making fun of me before I push you, man. He meant something else entirely, didn't he? Context can change everything. So just because you say, look, it's there, right there in the book. That's what it says. That doesn't mean you understand its context. That's also speaking without knowledge. That's also following something without fully knowing. And that's dangerous. That means you and I don't understand, and now we're imposing it on somebody else and making their life more difficult. So we should be careful, especially careful. You know, general advice about being patient or grateful and those kinds of things, those are fine. But then there are other things. I'll give you one example of taking things out of context. A mother came to me very upset with her son. Her son stopped praying and he was doing drugs and drinking and, you know, left the house and he was living with some girlfriend, or all kinds of sins, right? So, and she's a very pious religious woman, and she's just traumatized, constantly advising her son until she gave up. And she said, you know, I told him he's no longer my son. I find peace in my heart that I said that, because even Allah told Nuh alayhi salam, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٌ. Nuh alayhi salam, when he was on the ship and his son was still drowning, and he said, that's my family. Allah said to him, that's not your family, he's no good, basically. So she says, yeah, well my son is no good, so I get to say what? Nuh alayhi salam said, you're like my own mother, sit down for a second. Have you been preaching to your son for 950 years? And did Allah reveal to you the license to say he's no longer your son? Did he do that? How long have you been having this problem? For the last 9 months. Oh, okay, so you got about 949 years to go before you quote Nuh alayhi salam. Chill out, lady. That's still your son. You make dua for him, it's frustrating, but you don't get to do that. You don't get to pull an ayah of the Quran and slap him with it and say, I'm done. Nuh-uh. That's a crime. That's وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Remember these words again. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ. Don't become like people who say they heard, but they didn't really listen. They didn't really ponder. This is why Allah says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. If you remember nothing else from the khutbah, just remember this part. Allah Azza wa Jal describes people who don't think deeply about the Qur'an. Why don't they think deeply about the Qur'an? He says because they have locks on their heart, their own locks, أَقْفَالُهَا, their own locks placed on their hearts. Now what does that mean? That means you have a bias. I have a bias. There are some things that terrify me. There are some things that make me really angry. There are some things that I really want to impose on my son, or my daughter, or my spouse, or my parents even. I want to argue with them and I want to prove that I'm right. My heart is already locked that I'm going to prove them wrong. Then I'm going to come to the word of Allah and find an ayah, find a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, so I can quote it in their face, so I can win that argument and get them to do things I want them to do. I didn't come to Allah's book seeking Allah's pleasure. I wanted to come to it to find a weapon that I can use in my war of words. This is a lock on the heart too. That's a crime against Allah too. Just because somebody is quoting ayat of Quran, or words of our beloved Messenger ﷺ, doesn't mean they're not committing a crime. This is also وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. This is why Allah says your emotions will also be interrogated. وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. Maybe because of your anger, because of your rage, you started using the religious, the sacred words of Allah for your own purposes.